Last time we talked about the volumes of a general solid. This time we're going to talk about volumes of a very specific kind of solid that's easy to calculate, namely a solid of revolution. A solid of revolution is what you get when you take the region underneath a curve, say this region, and you spin it around the x-axis. So let me draw the mirror image of the curve. And the idea is that we're going to just spin it around and you get this solid region inside this curve. So now, if you have a solid revolution, whenever you cut it, whenever you just cut a slice, what you're going to find is if you take that slice and you lay it flat, you'll find that it is a perfect circle. And the radius of that circle is f of x. So that means that our area is pi times f of x squared. And so the volume of our solid revolution is the integral from a to b of pi times f of x squared dx, because after all, it's always the integral of a of x dx. So let's do an example. Let's see what happens when you take a semicircle of radius r and you spin it around the axis. Now, of course, if you take the semicircle of radius r and you reflect it, that just gives you a circle. And if you spin it around, that gives you a sphere of radius r. So we're really calculating the volume of a sphere. And the way we do that is we say, the semicircle, the equation of the semicircle is x squared plus y squared equals r squared. Solve for y, and that gives you y is the square root of r squared minus x squared. And that's what we call f of x. So our volume is the integral, let's see, this x goes from minus r to r of pi times the square root of r squared minus x squared all squared dx. So that's, we'll pull the pi out, integral minus r to r of r squared minus x squared dx. And that isn't too hard. It's pi times r squared x minus x cubed over 3 evaluated at r and at minus r. And that gives you pi times 2/3 r cubed minus negative 2/3 r cubed, because you plug in r here, you get r cubed, and then you subtract 1/3 of r cubed to get 2/3 of r cubed. And you get minus that when you plug in minus r. And the total comes out to 4/3 pi r cubed, which of course is the usual formula for the volume of a sphere.